Hey, it's Ross. Today, I'll walk you through all the essentials to work smarter with dependencies. Dependencies allow you to define the relationship between items and restructure your project timeline as item dates change. Let's see how it works. To get started with dependencies, you'll first want to ensure that your board has a date or timeline column. Either of these can be used to connect your board's content to the dependency column, which we'll add here. You're also going to want to add a Gantt chart. We'll get into the why shortly, but as for the how, click Add View and Gantt and you'll see your items populate on the chart. So, you have all the necessary columns and views to get started with dependencies on your board. What's next? If you're starting from scratch, go through and assign dates or timelines to your board's items. Then, let's backtrack and jump into the dependency column settings. When you configure dependencies for your board, you'll have the option of setting your dependency timeline as flexible, strict, or no action. Flexible will only move connected tasks if they overlap. Otherwise, you can freely move a task forward or back without changing future dates. Strict will apply the exact time change to subsequent tasks in the dependency chain. And no action won't move timelines, even if they overlap with other items they depend on. Choose the option that works best for you, but remember, you can always pop into the column settings again to change things later on. All right, you're just about ready to start using dependencies. Go through and set which items are dependent on other items. From there, you'll be able to select the dependency type for each relationship. First, we have the default finish to start type, where once task A is finished, task B can start. Start to start signifies once task A starts, then task B can start as well. Finish to finish, only once task A is finished, task B can also be finished. And finally, start to finish. Only once task A has started, task B is able to finish. No matter your workflow, we've got something for you. Okay, for the strict dependency option, you'll have the ability to create lead or lag times to define any necessary delays or opportunities to save time in a project plan. As a project progresses, your target dates will inevitably change. The best way to adjust the timing of your project is by utilizing our handy-dandy Gantt chart. As I mentioned earlier, when set to flexible, you can move each item freely without affecting other items unless there is overlap. If that happens, the timeline will intuitively shift to keep you on track. Cool, right? When set to strict, any change will maintain your date cadence for subsequent items. Each connected item will move by the same number of days, making it the perfect solution for your more rigid project plans. Alright, we went over a ton on today's video, but if you ever need further clarification or examples, head on over to the Help Center article linked in the description. With dependencies on monday.com, manage your projects more efficiently and keep tasks on track. Want to learn more about dependency options? Click our video here, or click our logo for more ways to get the most out of monday.com.